Hello everyone, this is Vrushali Patil from Prabhat Kids School. Welcome you all in this English period. Today we are going to see an interesting story, The Adventures of Toto by Ruskin Bond. Before starting this story, I want to show you one video. Watch it carefully.
The two tigers, becoming dangerous, believe that the storm is over and take to their games again, but Talum will not give up.
How naughty this monkey is. We know that the monkey is famous for its naughtiness. It creates nuisance everywhere. Naughty, troublesome and mischievous animal can be our pet. So let's enjoy the adventures of Toto in this lesson. Arthur's grandfather bought a monkey and kept it in his zoo. What happened there? Let's enjoy this lesson. The Adventure of Toto, written by Ruskin Bond. So let's see about the author. Ruskin Bond is an Indian author of British descent. He lives with his adopted family in Landur, Mysore, India. He is an Indian author of British descent. He is considered to be an icon among Indian writers and children's authors and a top novelist. He prolifically authored inspiring children's books and was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award to honor his work of literature. Let's see the introduction of the author. Ruskin Bond was born on May 19, 1934 at Kasauli, Himachal Pradesh. He is an Indian author of British descent. He is considered to be an icon among Indian writers and children's authors and a top novelist. Ruskin Bond wrote 500 novels, short stories, essays and poetry. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 for contributions to children's literature. Ruskin Bond wrote his first novel, Room on the Roof, when he was 17. Received the John Llewellyn Rim Memorial Prize in 1957. Since then, he has written over 300 short stories, essays and novels including Vagrants in the Valley and A Flight of Pigeons, and more than 30 books for children. Here is a list of his few famous novels. In 1987, the Indian Council for Child Education recognized his pioneering role in the growth of children's literature in India and awarded him the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for A Trees Still Grow in Dehra. He won the Padma Shri in 1999. Now let's see the story, The Adventures of Toto. The narrator's grandfather was very fond of animals. He had a nice collection of animals such as a tortoise, a tame squirrel, a pair of rabbits and a goat. But he didn't have a monkey. So one day he bought a baby monkey from a Tonga driver and named it Toto. Toto's arrival not only gladdened him but also enriched his private zoo. Toto was an attractive monkey with sparkling eyes and pearl white teeth. He would take special delight in scaring elderly Anglo-Indian ladies His tail added to his good look and also served as a third hand. Since grandmother did not have any interest in animals, she never welcomed grandfather with a new bird or animal in the house. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret until grandmother was in a good mood. Toto was temporarily kept in a little closet opening into the narrator's bedroom wall, where he was tied securely to a peg fastened into the wall. Being mischievous by nature, Toto began to create a nuisance from the very first day. He removed the ornamental wallpaper, pulled out the peg and tore off the narrator's blazer. Grandfather was quite happy to see Toto's performance. Toto was now transferred to a big cage in the servants' quarters where grandfather's other animals lived together. But Toto would create troubles for them. He did not let them sleep peacefully. His mischievous activities were increasing day by day. So when grandfather had to go to Saharanpur to collect his pension, he carried Toto with him in a big black canvas kit bag because his presence was kept secret for grandmother. Since there was no opening in the bag to allow his hands or face to come out, he would often jump inside the bag, making the bag roll about on the floor of the Dehradun railway platform. On reaching Saharanpur, Toto was found out by the ticket collector, who classified him as a dog because in a ticket collector's slip, the monkey was not mentioned as animal, dog was only mentioned, so that grandfather had to pay Toto's fare. Toto was finally accepted by the grandmother. He was then shifted to the stable where Nana, the family donkey, lived. But Toto continued teasing her, as a result of which they could never become friends. Toto loved to take bath in hot water in winter. One day, he nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive by inserting himself into a large kitchen kettle that had been left on the fire to boil for tea. It was grandmother who came to his rescue and saved him. Here are a few incidents of Toto. Similarly, in another incident, Toto grabbed a large dish of pulao which was kept for lunch in the dining table that afternoon. When grandmother entered the room, she screamed on seeing Toto stuffing himself with rice. He threw a plate on her face and a glass of water at the face of the narrator's aunt when they tried to stop him. On seeing grandfather, Toto ran away with the plate of pulao and made himself comfortable on the branch of a jackfruit tree and ate up every bit of the rice grain. Finally, Toto completed his excitement by throwing down the plate, chattering with delight when it broke into many pieces. Toto continued with his activities and tearing clothes to shreds, breaking plates and another utensils. Everyone in the family got fed up with his mischievous activities. Even grandfather began to think seriously about him. And finally, he took a hard decision to get rid of the monkey. He found the tonga driver and sold Toto back to him for only 3 rupees. The title, The Adventures of Toto, indicates directly at the central theme as well as the protagonist, Toto. The story is about Toto, the pet baby monkey, and his numerous adventures. Of course, the title does not clarify that who is Toto and what is Toto, but it does rouse the curiosity of the reader, which is one of the characteristics of a good title. In short, the title is suitable for this story. Grandfather bought a monkey called Toto from a tonga driver. Since the monkey is a wild animal, it is not suitable to be kept as a pet. But Toto was a naughty monkey. All the time he kept creating problems for others. The moment Toto entered the house, he started damaging the house and other things. He pulled out the pig, tore wallpapers and author's blazer. He never let other animals live in harmony. Be proud to be an expensive deal. So since the lesson describes the adventures of Toto, the title is appropriate. The author intends to convey the message that baby animals look cute and we are tempted to keep them as pets. However, we should not get carried away by their prettiness because each animal has its own characteristics. Some animals like monkeys are very mischievous. They can cause a lot of damage if one is not careful with them. So one should not keep animals as pets unless one has adequate information and skill to train and handle them. However, animals thrive better in their natural habitat. But being a wild animal, the monkey creates a lot of trouble and grandfather decided that the monkey would be happier with the tonga driver. Grandfather treats Toto with love and concern. So this lesson gives a message about animal rights and animal welfare. Always respect the animals and take care of them. As a human being, it's a responsibility to take care of animals as well as nature. It's a human responsibility. So take care. Thank you.